It's your boy here, man. Teflon Don underscore 215, man. We here at the round table, man. Hit this podcast out, man. Follow us on Instagram.
Hey, y'all. It's your girl, Deja, a.k.a. OADK, a.k.a. Deja Dem. I'm here and tapped into the realest podcast you probably ever watching, the round table.
Man, y'all already know, man. Y'all tuned into one of the realest, the illest, the livest podcasts ever. You know what I mean? Shout out to my co-host. I want everybody to tune in. Get down with the get down. Y'all already know. Your boy.
What's up, y'all? We back, man. It's the Ramsey podcast, man. You know what I'm saying? How y'all feeling, man?
It's your boy Aga, man.
Y'all know the one and only.
Snotty Nose.
The girl they come to see every time the episodes drop.
All right, man. I got time. We just was
bullshitting around. Yeah, as always, he on FanDuel. He just came home.
Yeah, definitely just came home, but I'm popped. I ain't got the 200 for that meal you talking about that y'all was talking about.
That's so bad.
Yeah, please do. Feed me.
Feed me. Saying.
Show me the way.
Show me the money.
Saying, like, would you rather take a person that's loyal with money? All right, for the females, like, would you rather your nigga be like with money and unloyal or loyal and broke? Like, which one? Like, do you care or do you care? Do it matter?
It definitely matter.
So if
you broken and you broken, you loyal, like, what? I mean, you know.
On what? Like, that, no.
Not taking it. Get somebody else to do it.
Damn.
She signed up for that shit, nigga.
It's too much shit. They got
no chick with no broke ass nigga.
Well, there's nothing you, it's not, man, and there's no shade, right? Because you would want to take a loyal man. But you loyal to me and you ain't trying to get, you ain't loyal to yourself. Why the fuck you ain't trying to get no money?
He just probably not getting over the hump, though. It's probably just some, like, he just ain't, you know what I mean?
We'll be gonna help you try to get over that hump. And if you can't get over it, then you gotta go.
But he loyal with shit, like, you ain't gotta worry about nothing.
You broke.
So, like.
There's nothing I can do with you. Bills gotta get paid. Gas is very high.
But you make enough money to cover all that.
Why the fuck is I fucking you? I could fuck myself.
You can't fuck yourself.
The rose works very good.
That shit don't penetrate.
At this point, it don't even matter. He don't got no fucking money. So what you want, penetration or check?
What you say, Marion Pack? What do you got that Marion meat?
I don't give
but
a
he broke.
Fuck. Yeah, he and then loyal. I'm still getting up, going to work, working 16-hour shifts while you fucking reaping the benefits at home with your fucking feet crossed.
But he loyal. Right,
when you come home, you go.
There was a house.
You go pogo jump on that motherfucking on that pole to me.
Dick ain't everything. Sorry.
No, but I'm saying taking care of the house. He making
so
sure,
you
like,
just a house nigga. Like, you in a house nigga. Like, who clothed you? I gotta clothe you? I gotta buy you sneakers and shit?
He ain't really pressed about that. He might just wear it.
I don't want you. I don't want you.
And some Converse.
Converse.
But he love you.
Chucks?
Yeah.
Not nobody. What the fuck?
He love you a lot. And any bit, but he look good. Brother Yusuf. Every female. When he's stepping in, he's stepping in.
Brother Yusuf broke his shit, sister. Good
but
sister.
Every time he step in the room, he turn his, like, no matter where y'all go.
He gonna turn his, and they gonna turn right the fuck back around when they realize there's lint in the pockets.
Why? Because everybody's looking for money. Is that the truth?
Nobody is. You got bills. So you fucking a broke bitch? Is you gonna take a bad bitch with her own money, but she fuck around a little bit, or you gonna take a hit bitch?
Man,
or you gonna take a hit bitch?
That's loyal. Yep.
That's loyal?
Yep.
She broke though.
Yep.
No money.
Yep.
No nothing.
Yep.
You gonna help her get it together?
Yeah, she gonna get it together.
We gonna build together.
Yeah, we gonna build together.
It ain't just like you got bitch get out. Like, you gotta get out.
Cause guess what? The cameraman ain't fucking my bitch.
that ugly bitch get fucked.
She just said she loyal. She ain't doing nothing.
Mm. You said, oh, you just said these hoes ain't loyal. None of them.
I know that, but I'm just saying what you said. I'm going off of what you said. You said,
I mean, this was actually him time.
But you know,
but you know what I mean? You made a statement.
So you gonna keep the loyal bitch? And she
I want the loyal bitch.
As long as she in the house cooking and cleaning and everything.
I don't give a fuck what she doing. As long as she ain't giving that hole up.
That's a bit much. That's a shame. That's a fucking shame. All niggas care about is pussy. There it is.
That's my
pussy. There you have it. There you have it. They don't care about nothing else. I never said that. That was the question that was asked.
Cause, like, if I only care about this pussy, now I care about loyalty and morals. So, like,
loyalty and morals. She don't got no fucking money. She don't got no money.
She gonna get down with
how long?
She might got dropped.
What if she don't want to go to school?
She gonna do.
What if she lazy? What if she want to be a housewife? She just want to be taken care of. Cause that's what it's given. You said as a house nigga, right? He don't do shit. He cook, he clean, fuck you. Right. That's it.
Now if she one of them type bitches, I don't really care for them type bitches, but
that's what you want to settle for.
They say stereotype that shit is a man supposed to provide for his home. So if she's just a
housewife, in a modern day and age.
Thank you. Me in a modern day and age.
Ain't nobody, if a bitch wanna lay around all day and be a housewife, she's a fucking bum.
So why?
No shade, because if that nigga lose everything, what can you do to help him? You don't got no income, you ain't chasing a bag, you ain't doing nothing. All the fuck you doing is dusting and mopping, bitch. You better go start a cleaning business.
But she might got driving that bitch. She don't know.
She don't got it. She broke and she loyal. That's it. And she just at home waiting for you.
She's saying she don't got no ambition.
And she ugly as shit at that. So I ain't gotta give.
I'm gonna choke. She just
give me the bad bitch.
That's fucking everybody.
But she got we gonna make this shit work.
Dang.
We gonna make this shit work.
Dang.
So I said to say as long as your nigga winning, he can do whatever the fuck he want.
At the end of the day, every guy is going to cheat.
No, they're not.
Every man is capable of cheating. Sit here and say they ain't. Have you ever cheated before? Or you going to plead the fifth?
No, I'm not going to plead the fifth.
Have you cheated? Have you cheated?
I don't.
Have you cheated? Yes or no?
I'm not going to call it cheating, though.
What if you did anything that you ain't want your girlfriend to do is cheating?
I was doing everything my girl was doing, so
Did you cheat before? So you ain't tell me you never cheated.
If she cheated, I'm cheating.
No, ain't nobody trying to hear this shit.
Did you ever cheat before?
It's safe to say, y'all, this nigga ain't no cheater. That's good. You cheated before? I know you did. You cheated before? I know you did.
If she cheated, the story is,
this nigga cheated, but your bills was paid. When niggas cheat, they gotta pay how they weigh. That's it. They hurt you, you hurt they fucking pocket.
No, then that's not a relationship.
What is it?
Why?
Niggas cheat. You be in a relationship with a girl and you still step out. We in a relationship for 6 years, 7 years, and this nigga fucking off. It's baby, and she broke.
So what?
All right, but there you is. He don't care about you since he don't love you.
That's not dope.
He don't. All he care about is you not giving your pussy away. That's it. He don't want you to go and get no money. He don't care that you don't want to go get your own money. He don't care that you want
to go get her own money. I mean, it's time we're going to figure something out.
She should be figuring it out. How old is she? Because if she over 35, it's over for her.
And she don't got no kids yet? 35?
She got four kids.
She came with me. She came to me with four kids. I'm not even taking nobody with four kids. So how about this conversation now? If she got four kids, that ain't even my type of shit.
She got two kids.
That's a little too many.
Oh, wow.
I ain't going to lie. I'm not coming.
So y'all don't like dating girls with like six kids, four or five kids?
What?
Right?
Who trying to date somebody with six kids?
Why not? What if you let it? What if you fall in love with the lady and you don't know that she got all these kids?
No, you gonna know.
You not.
She had six kids from you, and you were able to fall in love with you. Bitch, you better cut her the fuck off because she
a magician.
She had six kids the whole time. And now she just staying at your house every night. You just like, damn, I'm a
kid. You can never come. Yeah, you make the seventh.
She like, well, you know, I got six already.
Pop up with the number she is.
Yeah,
nah,
so nah. You not dating girl? You not dating nobody with six kids?
Six?
Yeah. But niggas out here doing this standard. It's a double standard.
No,
niggas can have six kids and seven different baby moms.
Niggas can have more than that.
Six kids and seven baby
moms. Yeah, niggas can have that.
And you would the bitches just. Supposed to stay.
Because guess what? As long as you're the new baby mom, it don't matter to you. It don't matter how many kids.
I ain't being the baby mom. I'm going to be the bitch that got. I'm going to be the bitch that get everything. I don't want no kids from
Because like, at the end of the day, like.
If you get pregnant, you're not getting rid of it. If he won, you're not.
No, I am getting rid of it, nigga. You got six kids and seven baby moms. I'm cool.
If he take the kids.
Even that's how niggas be moving.
That's me. I'm out that one then. If she coming with like kids, like, and then you broke with kids.
Yeah,
I'm not coming alone buying.
And she ugly.
Four pair of sneakers. Yeah, now you got ugly chick broke kids. I gotta buy your kids sneakers.
And then with you,
she ain't got no choice but to be loyal.
She ain't got no choice.
She got no choice but to be loyal. Like, you have to be. Like,
I ain't fucking this up.
Like, seriously.
Nail you in his house. He got a feng shui home.
I ain't fucking this up.
Nail you in his house.
Shit, you can get a bad bitch. I ain't trying to fuck that up. And she broke a bad bitch and broke. Ain't trying to fuck that up. Uh-uh. I ain't fucking that up.
Nah.
Give me the bad bitch.
I ain't
never cheating on my
nigga.
But I don't know. But at this point, that's like putting like nails. Money is more valuable than loyalty now.
No, it's actually not. Oh, but no, it's not because. But it's like if you don't have the drive to want to fix yourself, like no man should not have to tell you, all right, boo, you should just go get a job.
Money controls everything.
Go to school. Money don't control everything. But
money
right
make
now,
the world go round. Money is, make a girl go down. Mm-hmm.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, money make the world go round, and money will make a girl go down. I don't give a fuck who she is.
Really?
Yep. She can be the baddest bitch in any amount, and you got that money, and you want that bad, super bad bitch to suck your dick, she gonna suck your dick for that paper.
How much?
Exactly.
How much money?
My money unlimited. So my money unlimited.
So if the bitch tell you give me 50 bands right now.
Yep.
You giving it up for the pussy.
That ain't no money to
No, because that's what you want, though, right? You going to pay the 50 grand because you want...
Because money...
Because that's what you want.
She say she not giving a fuck about that paper, but that 50 grand, she going to go down and top me, right?
Mm.
I'm like, damn, this bitch got some pretty ass, and I just want to see her lips wrap around his dick. I'm going to give her 50 bands, and that ain't nothing to me. 50 bands like $50.
It's safe to say 97% of the females are like a jump on there for $50,000 just to suck like without nobody knowing what's going on. No, I'm just saying.
They is.
Especially on a secret.
Yeah, I'm just gonna throw the exaggerated number out there. I'm just throw the $50,000 out there.
Fuck the $50,000. We're gonna be realistic. $500. That bitch gonna blow your top. I got $500 for a dick suck.
Like right now, MPUA money over?
Yep. I got $500 for a dick suck, and then I ain't gonna tell nobody.
Ain't no way.
Shit like this.
Ain't no way.
Like, if ain't nobody gonna... Fuck it, nigga. It's
$500.
Dang. I'm gonna fuck it.
Raise your daughters right.
My car insurance $500. I need to pay that shit this month anyway, so...
Raise your daughters right.
Let me blow your whistle. Yeah. Let me pay...
Raise your daughters right, ladies.
She gonna blow that flute. She gonna flute that nigga for $500. So 50 bands... And you want one of them Instagram bitches to sign for 50 bands? Shit, that's a lot of fucking money. That's down there 100K.
So
she gonna bring her girlfriend. They probably take turns, bitch.
You for $500?
No, 50 bands.
Oh,
they gonna split it. And they smart, bitch. You gonna make 25? I'm gonna make 25. Yeah, I mean, she gonna bring her girlfriend. The bad.
Selling your soul.
No, they ain't gonna.
That's selling your soul.
They ain't selling their soul. That's what these hoes do. That's what these hoes do anyway.
They hold it. They make it
work. I mean, prostituting.
That's the same thing as if you at the mall and I'm like,
yeah, no, it's not. No, it's not. You right. Telling me right now I got $50,000 for you to suck my dick? That's basically you a dick sucker then. So you get paid to suck dick.
You suck dick for free, don't you?
If I like the nigga, I'm going to get some out of that shit, but I'm not. Just you not about to be like, oh yeah, I got $50,000 for you right now, suck my dick. Like, what? Who the fuck you think you talking to?
But he not going to say it like that. He going to say
no, if a nigga got 50, no, if a nigga got $50,000, he going to talk dirty to you. Bitch, I got $50,000 for you right now. Suck my dick.
So
for,
I got $50,000 for this dick on
you. Yeah, that's how you talking. Bitch, I got 50 bands right now.
$50,000
he ain't never going to be like, yeah, baby, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got no niggas not on there. Now, the nigga might low, the nigga with the 500 might, yeah, I got something. I got a little 500. Like, you know, he going to sweet talk you. But a nigga with 50 bands just can just get that way freely. He don't give a fuck about you, girl. Suck my dick. He got a 50,000.
Put this dick on your tongue. I ain't even said
no. Right in your face.
You gotta say some fly shit. You gotta say some fly shit.
Smack the bitch with the 50 beans. Yeah. Pick this shit up, bitch.
Let me smack that.
Go get me another one.
Put this dick on your tongue, bitch. Like, stop playing. Man, I got 50 bands for you to put this dick on your tongue.
And I'm walking right the fuck out.
Matter of fact, look. You and your bitch, I think y'all bad bitches. Y'all bitches broke for real. I got 50 bands for
that's me. How the niggas is talking. So, guess what though? But bitches is so money hungry, they gonna chase that shit. They gonna fuck.
Girl, this nigga was talking crazy. Tell me, tell some you and your bad friend. For real? Oh, he want us broke.
Oh, they gonna make it seem like it was like.
They, over you know, they gonna keep it to each other, but when they leave out that room.
Like it was a good talk. Oh, like it was a compliment. Like,
gonna be like bitch, he said we was bad, bitch. Yes. Well, girl, we met this nigga and he said we was looking.
He gave us 20.
And I'm the friend. Y'all bitches was in there eating each other pussy, wasn't y'all?
I hope they was, because this shit turned into a whole event for that 50. It might start off with put that dick on your tongue, but then next thing you know, we having fun.
And what you doing with that? And what, y'all, then y'all get 25 a piece. What y'all doing with it? Like, bitches just
man, that's a lot of money.
It is, but what are you doing with it though? Like, what you about to do?
25K.
Shit, they just made that 50. That's their profession.
Yeah,
that's dick suckers.
Yeah, that's their profession.
But you know, a lot of them bitches that everybody look up to on Instagram is professional dick suckers for that.
I can believe it.
Professional dick suckers.
I ain't knocking
all them bitches with the. With the million, 100 and something followers, 100 and
bitches be buying them followers too. Y'all bitches ain't low either.
But them bitches be professional dick suckers. Especially all them bitches be on there showing ass and titties all day long.
You just was
posting the ass. They professional dick suckers. Mm. If you got the money, all that thirsty shit, that's why they want you to look on that joint and be like, dang, this bitch ass fat as shit. You got that money?
I don't think that's why they post the bitch.
I think that's why they posting that thirsty shit. They
bitches be some girls really be loving themselves. Like,
no, they posting and that be, shit.
And if you I mean, I don't agree. Like I'm not getting on Instagram.
You want to see something her fucking name, and then you gonna see the at name for OnlyFans right next to it too.
Yeah, I ain't never been. You pay for OnlyFans before?
Fuck no.
Never. I'm not sucking no fucking dick.
Any bitch with OnlyFans is sucking your dick for less than $10K.
Yeah, because you could get $10 and you pay $10, she showing her pussy, so I can believe
it. Yeah, now that's a $500 dick suck. But she be one of the bad bitches. But
that's a big $500
dick suck real quick.
I'm not part of
it. You never
those bitches was thirsty, what? Bro.
You was on Make Page before?
What?
What about you?
Yeah, I've been probably been there too.
I know he's lying. He is lying.
Craig, listen.
I just came home.
No,
Craigslist is crazy.
That's before back. It was Backpage. I mean, it was Craigslist, then Backpage.
So you mean to tell me you could get pussy off of Craigslist? I thought you looked for houses and shit on
it. No, it was Craigslist before it was anything. Remember they was getting busted on Craigslist, and I was like what 16, 17 doing Craigslist.
So let me ask you fucked a smoker before?
Yeah, everybody did. That's so drunk.
Everybody's so drunk. Fuck the smoker.
You gotta understand. Like,
and some niggas said they didn't though. So y'all hear this? The niggas said every.
You so drunk in my era. I've been so drunk since I was like 12.
That's what I'm about to say. And the smokers ain't these smokers that's out here.
So y'all was like Miss Pam and them.
Like your aunt who just come out like the aunts and all that shit. They come out and be like 11:30 at night. And like they doing something.
All the way real. And it's a real fucking story. I was fucking a smoker in the alley and got robbed.
No shit.
I'm hitting a smoker. My man ran past the alley like, yo. And I heard him as he slide past like screaming, yo. I got the smoker bent over. Like, what the fuck was that? I go to pick out the alley. I see niggas laying everybody down on the corner. Lay the fuck down. So I try to come out the alleyway and sprint. Nigga grab me. Don't fucking move. I'm like, oh shit.
And
I'm calling young boy, beeper. I just graduated 8th grade.
Oh my God.
I had my graduation money in my pocket and everything.
Oh, from the graduation book. Remember the graduation book? Oh my God. They taped the shit. Yep.
The shit tape, yep. They laid me down in the little block, took all my graduation money. I'm so much of a nut when I was getting robbed. I took my shoe off and gave the rest of the work. Hold up, I got some work in my shoe too.
You was too grown. You was 8. Yeah. I mean, you was coming out the 8th grade. Yeah. Like, you was not supposed to be doing that shit.
I said, hold on, y'all forgetting something. I got something in my shoe too.
Your friend's bike was like, what the fuck are you doing?
I gave him the shit in my shoe. A hard dad's home.
Yeah, no.
I ran that little blood. Like, you just robbed me, man.
Oh, my. What you was doing, huh?
Her name was Tucci. Yep, Tucci. Tucci was one of the fiends that had a turkey too. She's the top of all of us.
And Tucci need an ass whoop.
Tucci was like,
you was in 8th grade.
So what? She was topping us in the alleyway.
That is traumatizing.
She did that thing to me because she turned me out. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah,
she that ass over. I said,
you know how in 8th grade you're 13 years old. You like 12 and 13.
I didn't think I could fit a condom. I'm like, fit a condom more and do what? She's like, I'm about to bend it over. I said, for real? I'm hitting that joint. I'm like, oh shit!
I'm so
niggas
bad.
Like niggas right laying niggas down while I'm hitting that joint.
In the alley,
butt stinking everything.
Dirty. That's how you know. Like, and you like 12 and 13. How old was this lady?
She probably like 30.
That's why I said the smokers back then, they wasn't like them old beat up smokers you seen.
It don't matter. You still 30 years old. He's fucking 12. So? 13. Like, you out of pocket.
Yeah, she was out of pocket, but
pocket. She was giving me the yams.
You trying to get to the yams.
That's what was going on, man.
That's just crazy. Yams. Yeah, it's ill. You said a butt stink.
Yeah, a butt did stink, though. It did. And that joint was bent over and fat. It smelled like she ain't white. It smelled like she had a little dookie smudge in it.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
But you I ain't nasty.
Nasty. Shit. Yeah, shuffle. Like, dirty as shit though. We not on it. Pray for watch your son.
I think everybody's in the younger days fuck the fiend.
I don't believe that. But now, if a nigga fuck the fiend, he at the age of 20,
19. You shouldn't be fucking fiends no more.
No, I feel like you at the age you should have been lost your virginity to somebody your age and got some real pussy.
Now at 12 or 13 you in the streets and you get a chance at a fiend. Young ones hitting that fiend.
I just think your generation and our generation was like different. Like just like y'all said, the smokers back. You couldn't tell when people were smoking.
You couldn't tell. That's what it said.
Like. No, but what's our generation?
Y'all, you an 80s baby. All right. Yeah.
Oh, you 90s?
Yes.
Damn. Y'all get shit.
And then it's a little bit. But I hung around y'all generation. But so I knew, like, niggas would be lying. Like, I ain't never fucking smoked before. You're lying.
Oh, no, niggas be lying.
You're lying.
Niggas will lie about shit like that, but I don't understand why. Everybody fuck the smoker. If niggas was running on work phones, anything, and fuck that, early 2000s niggas was in fiends. They frauding if they said they wasn't. Early 2000s, nah. If you was working on phones and shit, and them phones are jumping, and you go to certain fiends' house and they're like, fiends be having nice houses clean. You got different type of smokers. You got crackhead smokers.
You got functional smokers.
Go ahead, go to work, come home,
take a shower,
do that shit. You come in that joint, oh, I got something cooking. Like, no, Miss Pam, what you need? Oh, I need three, baby. And she had the little robe on, that joint, a little turkey, that joint bounce. You like, damn.
You don't need no money for me.
You like, damn, Miss Pam. Miss Pam, so you don't be messing around? She like, what you mean, baby? Like, you don't be like doing a little something? Like, you a little cute ass. You gotta stop playing. Oh, Miss Pam, you better stop playing.
You fucking somebody.
Now you in there hit somebody aunt.
That's a bit much. I'm so glad my sons ain't gonna know nothing about this life. Cause if
my sons gonna still be around, they
if my sons they ain't gonna be do. I mean, they gonna play lacrosse and shit like that. They gonna be playing soccer and golf.
No. Don't raise them in South Philly no more. You gotta get them the fuck out of here.
Oh, we gonna be here. We gonna be out of here.
Yeah, get them out of here fast. Cause they grow up and wanna be from wherever you got them living at.
Nowhere. Nowhere. They ain't from nowhere.
Seventh Street, but anywhere around. I ain't living there. Anywhere you got them in that hood. Any hood they grow up in and live in, that's where they gonna be from.
They ain't gonna know nothing about nothing.
All right, they gonna be hitting them fucking fiends.
No, they ain't. I'm gonna be whooping their fucking ass.
Y'all look just like
I'm gonna be whooping their ass. Ain't no 30-year-old should be fucking on no 12-year-old. Like that's a bitch. You need to go to jail.
I need to wash my tissues.
But what I'm saying is,
bad as shit when I be saying that type of shit.
Y'all females, when y'all be like 15, 16, y'all be chasing the niggas that be like 20.
I never did it. I never liked the older guys. I never dealt with them.
They do. They be chasing the older.
No, it is some people who do. I've never been one of the girls to be attracted to an older guy. Like it creeped me out. Like I literally just started liking dark skinned niggas. Like no shit.
like 16, yeah, but all of 16, 17, like
no, this generation now, the 16-year-olds they fucking
and niggas be
36. Like you 16, like a nigga, you nasty. Like this little girl, I don't even know how wise.
Hold on. Niggas 36 fucking
16, 17 or get them little bitches is sneaking in clubs and shit, getting fake IDs. Little girls are still in high school. The little girls is grown as shit. I'm talking about like really just went through a phone and seen the little bitch like in her panties and bras, like ass bent over to a 27-year-old. You in 8th grade.
I'm smoking that nigga.
Yeah, bro.
But how you know? How would you know?
And that's
the little girls be built.
Yeah,
you and the moms be lying on wearing crop top shirts and shit.
You know the crazy part? The only way you would know is like
mindset.
When school start, those same little motherfuckers got their uniforms all going to the motherfucking school.
You see her, she hot in the shit.
All of a sudden they was running, you be like, yo, that's out of pocket.
These niggas is out of pocket.
No, they is, because they know.
You a fucking pervert.
But imagine, okay, so let's say, let's reverse roles, though. 38,
30, anything, and you, come on, man, you know if she fucking young.
I feel like 30 and up, yeah, you should know. You could tell a kid, but.
You sick, nigga.
If she like 16 and a nigga like 26.
But, you know, that's cool for a female that's older than a fucking younger guy.
And that's where the double standard.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like that. That's life.
No, I feel like it's creepy as shit, though.
It ain't. Because all the shit you be saying, like, when the teachers be fucking the students, like,
that's
I'm not
creepy.
Telling. You yeah, telling?
I'm not telling. I never
would. Like, one of my teachers wanted to fuck me when I was younger.
I never would have told on
her. I
took the case and I said, I don't know why the fuck they even put her in there. Yeah, she never did that.
She never did that. I would have been like this. She never did that. Shit. You get straight A's and you get pussy.
But yeah, here it is now. Let's okay.
Mom's gonna be proud. Son on the road and I'm busting my teacher ass. Yeah.
I'm not telling what? Nobody. I'm not telling my mom. Like, cause she.
I don't even want to tell my homie because he might be ahead because he can't
he
get
might tell.
Like,
you're going to
fucking.
Yeah, that'd be fucking Miss Sky.
That'd be fucking Miss Sky, yo.
In the courtroom.
Oh, she don't be giving me nothing. Fuck that. I'm telling. No, bro, she going to jail. Oh, you drunk, yo, chill. No, I'm telling, man, but I'm about to bribe with her. She got to give me something, too. But that bitch better give me an A1, everything. I'm telling.
Nutty.
And he walk in pants. I know you fucking my friend too, Miss Sky.
He's drawn, like,
you better put an A on my test. I don't know. I just never felt like I never was like the older guy.
That's
like
double standards though. For
I feel cool, like yeah. No, I don't agree with it at all.
What for?
On either way, I don't agree with it at all. Like I don't agree with.
But that's why they call cougars, ain't they?
Yeah, but a cougar to me is like you in your 50s and you might be fucking a nigga in his 30s. Like you get what I'm saying? Like, but that's a cougar. But that's still a cougar. But that's still, she 50 years old. She get
out. She 50 and she fucking 19. Nigga that's barely legal. He just turned 18.
She nasty as shit. That's your grandson.
He grown though. He 18.
No fucking grown.
So not, so basically like.
So you will let her. So if just one of your sons was messing with, he 19. He messing with a 48 year old. Like you okay with that?
Yeah, if she look good. He got a nice little Jerry Stackhouse 40 years.
No,
she stacked up and all.
No, she's too grown. She's too grown.
I just seen this. They said, boy, Instagram said all the older women look better than the younger women.
No, they do. They do. All they do. The young women, girls look young. Tight, I mean, the young girls look old as shit.
Yeah, all the older women are looking real good.
Yeah, they take care. They taking care of themselves.
50,
mm-hmm.
55, them bitches mm-hmm. looking real good.
Cause I ain't gonna lie, Barb look gooder than a motherfucker. Tasties.
Oh, yeah.
All right. She look gooder than a motherfucker.
Yeah.
She look gooder than a motherfucker.
And she give a lot of the young girls a run for their money.
So,
but so my son, 19, 20, hitting this tasty. I'm not mad at him.
No. No way, though. You ain't got to be mad at him, but you mad at her, though.
Son.
No, because he got parts of the team.
All right, so we going to flip your daughter. 19. But why, though?
Because it's
that's your fresh-ass daughter. Get your daughter. She too high.
Nope.
She fucking out of both sides of the penis. Your daughter initiating the shit. The little girls is wanting them in. They pursuing them. So it's okay for your son to fuck a 48-year-old and he 19, but if your daughter 19 and that's she wanna fuck with an old lady, that's crazy.
That's all it been like.
Yeah,
all
so just cut both shit short.
No, it's cool for a man to do that. He's a man.
It ain't.
He's a man.
It ain't.
It's just like that's cool for a man to go ahead and fuck 20 different little girls.
Mm-hmm.
But your daughter, you're not gonna be one of her out here fucking 20 different little boys.
Yeah, no.
But you're going to be cool with your son doing
it. I'm not never going to be cool with her. I'm beating the bitch ass. If she, if the bitch even 10 years older than my son, I'm beating her up.
No, you can't do that.
Yes, I can.
You can't beat you.
I'm going to be that mom, yes. Man, this ain't no whole house. I ain't bringing all these bitches in and out of here. Ain't nobody going upstairs. The little bitch come here. Y'all can sit on the porch.
Where she fucked you up though?
Who?
No, I'm just saying.
She getting smoked.
Yeah, you want to kill her. You can't.
Listen.
You're just a drawn ass mom.
I am. Because you want to know, it's no boundaries nowadays. Everybody want to be a friend and not a parent. You got me fucked. We could. You gonna respect me though? I'm your mom. But for anything, like we could kick it. You could talk to me about it. But you think you about to walk in the house with a bitch my age? Talking about mom, that's my girlfriend. No, the fuck it ain't.
I'm with the school together.
Yeah, I'm be out of fuck up, and I probably already beat you up back in the day.
Hold on, a bitch from your school.
And she like, yeah, I know your mom. What you doing?
She's not gonna ever be disrespectful when come to the house though.
But niggas do it, you know. But boys be like, "That's my mom. I got it." Like, man, she already
like.
Cause when I'm 50, my son told me 25.
I ain't gonna lie though. A couple of my mom friends was like,
wanted to get you some.
Yeah, like.
Did your mom know?
I told her. She's and my mom wasn't feeling that.
Yeah, bitch, I'm gonna knock you the fuck out. You touch my son, like you watched them grow up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie though. You said somebody that watched me grow up.
Oh wow!
Yeah,
and she should be ashamed.
No, she ain't ashamed.
You still see her to this day?
They too. They was too considered adults.
No, I just think it's creepy. But shit.
I think she waited for me to get to a grown man.
It don't matter if you know
she
my.
She waited. She lamped on it.
Yeah.
You a fucking creep. Like that's waited. Some creepy ass shit. Like I don't like shit like that. That ain't true.
But that's a predator for a man to wait for a young girl.
No, definitely a predator. He's all the way out of power.
He's giving R. Kelly.
No, it's deeper than R. Kelly. You waiting?
He
so she's 6 and you just want to lamp for years? So she hits 16, 17, you just want to wait 10, 11 years?
And that's what you know what's so crazy? Because I had guys do that to me. Like, they didn't see me at 15. Like, when you turn 18, you going to be... I used to be like, ew.
Yeah, he should have been...
Like, when you 18, you going to be the shit when you turn 18. Yeah, nope.
Yeah, but
Man, you can't even say that. How you even fit your mouth to say that? Like, how old was you at the time?
I probably was like 15. Man, 14, 15.
He was lamping me for 4 years.
But I'm not gonna lie though, my friends was fucking. So you know they put us together. Like
birds of a feather flock together.
But that's not true, because some of my friends is whores. Like out here giving that shit up. Like 14, 15. I'm talking about coming to school, passion marks and shit. I'm scared of shit. I'm still giving out all these at dollar parties. Y'all going hard.
Giving out a
wall,
fresh little hot cocktail.
No, you going to a party. That's when you get it's the party.
You go to the party, you seek out the wall, like that's your mission, like let me get to the
you
wall.
You go to the nigga that you like, but we the same age though. That's the thing. We the same age. Oh, we playing catch a girl, freak a girl though. Bitches is really fucking.
So when you was 17, 18, you ain't never like the older guys from the block
up the block? It was like a crush, but I feel like you always had a crush on people. But to pursue it, fuck no. My dad and my brothers know everybody's over.
Yeah, man.
Keep going.
But you know, it's safe to say, man, that was...
Watch your sons and your daughters.
Please. Yeah, that's all I can say. Please.
Yeah, it's a lot of free time.
Man. Oh, wait, but it's safe to say...
You gonna beat the broke bitch, that ugly bitch, the lawyer?
I want the lawyer. I take lawyer over anything else. What about you?
I
take
some
lawyers if you need it. Lawyer? Morals are...